So let me know if the screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Good
morning. Are you tired or what? Active?
Oh, sir.
Active?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because I see very less students, around 30 only. What happened to others? Are they in the beginning or are in festival mode?
Assignment.
Okay. Hope you all submitted the second assignment.
Yes, sir.
I will check it. Yes. Fine. So probably we can complete our syllabus of loader today. Let me see. If that is done, I can give the final questions on this and as well as the syllabus for the test. And anyhow, so let us come back to the discussion of the loaders and linkers. So in the previous class, we have discussed until mission dependent as well as mission independent features of loaders, including relocation, how linking is performed, and algorithm and data structures, which are dependent features, and automatic library search and loader options, which are independent features of loaders. Now let us get into the design options of a loader. That's what I said in the previous class. Loader options are different. Loader options means how to load the program or how to control the program at the time of loading. So using your maybe a command oriented operating systems, you can control them using include, delete, change and stuff like that. But what we're discussing now is a loader design options, meaning that how we can design a loader. Similar to that, we had something in assembler as a one pass assembler and a two pass assembler. That was a design, sorry, multi-pass assembler. They were the design options. So two pass assembler we have discussed. Later we looked at, can we have a one pass assembler? Can we have a multi-pass assembler? Similarly, now also we have been discussing so far as a, which is a two pass loader. That is what we have discussed so far is a two pass loader. Now we would like to know, apart from two pass loader, is there any other loaders that we have? So can you recall which are the loaders we have discussed so far? From the beginning, maybe for last 5-6 hours, we have touched upon three loaders. Can you recall what are they?
So bootstrap.
Bootstrap loader, perfect. That was one. Next. One is, of course, the two-pass loader, which I've discussed. So one is bootstrap, other was regular loader, what I've seen, two-pass. One more. Absolute loader. Absolute loader, right? So one is an absolute loader, other one is a bootstrap loader. The second, third one is a two-pass loader, what I've discussed. The two-pass loader, what I've discussed so far, is called as a linking loader. You should remember the name. The link, because in the exam, they might ask you, write the algorithm for a linking loader. Don't feel it is something different. It is the one and the same that what we have discussed. The loader, what I've discussed so far, is called as a linking loader, meaning that it performs linking also whenever there is a need for it, then performs the loading and goes for the execution. If that is the case, such type of loaders are called as a linking loader. So one is absolute loader, other one is a bootstrap loader, third one is a linking loader that we have seen. In addition to this, we see two more loaders today. What are they? Linkage editor and dynamic linking. So linkage editor and dynamic linking, these are the two more additional loader concepts what we are going to see as well as the loader design option. Totally then we'll have a five design options, not four, it will be five. One is absolute loader, bootstrap loader, linking loader, linkage editor and dynamic linking. We know what is a absolute loader. Absolute loader is one which loads the entire program at the given location. It will make sure that the program will be loaded only at the location that is going to be given or that is given already as part of the object program. If that is the case, we call that program as a absolute program. So nothing to worry about that. There is no relocation required there. If possible, linking might be done. Otherwise, it will be loading the program in the given location. Next, bootstrap loader. Bootstrap loader is a special absolute loader which is going to load only the operating system when the system is getting booted. Otherwise, it is not going to do anything else. That is a special loader. Then linking loader, which is a typical loader what we have in every operating system, which makes sure that whatever the program we submit for execution will be taken care in terms of memory allocation, in terms of linking process if it is required, in terms of relocation wherever needed, and finally loading the program into the system. This was a typical process what we have in a linking loader. In addition to that, we can come across two types of loaders by name linkage editor or a dynamic linking. So what will happen in the linking loader, let us see, so that comparing will be easier. So what we will be doing now in this exercise, maybe an hour from now, we know what is linking loader. We try to compare this with a linkage editor and a dynamic linking. So before going to that, let us see what is a linking loader. A linking loader, what we have done so far is, it is going to perform all the requirements of linking, relocation, and loading when you submit the program for the execution. For example, I have program A, program B, program C. What are they now? They're existing independently. Now I'm submitting these three for execution. Why I'm submitting these three? Because I know that these three have some interrelation. One depends on the other. So what I'm doing now, A, B, C programs, I'm submitting for the execution. When I submit them for execution, during that time, that means once I submit them for execution, at that time, they will be considered for a possible linking and possible relocation and the necessary loading into the system. If that is the case, we call them as a linking loader, meaning that linking happens when you submit the program for the execution. We call in terms of a at the time of execution. When you are going to submit the execution or when you submit the program for execution, at the time of execution, your linking is going to happen. If that is the case, we call it as a linking loader. Then the other two, the linkage editor and dynamic linking, differ from this. So if you know the linking loader, then it is easy to understand or make sure what is the key difference between linkage editor and dynamic linking. So linking loader is the one which performs the necessary linking, the necessary relocation, and the loading when the program is submitted for the execution. It will not do before that, or it will not do during that time. So that is the concept of a linking loader. Then what is a linkage editor? Linkage editor is the one which performs the necessary linking beforehand. It will perform earlier only, then keeps the merged version as a repository. Later it will do the loading into the program. So a linkage editor, as the name says, it is going to have a linking being performed beforehand, before execution is there. It will keep entire thing in one particular place. Later, when you submit for execution, then probably they will be considered for the execution. So linking is going to happen in prior to execution. Suppose you want to execute tomorrow, but linkage would have been done today only. If that is the case, we call that as a linkage editor. So this is what we are going to consider for the linkage editor concept. Then the third one is dynamic linking. So one is linkage editor is well before the execution or loading. The linking loader is at the time of loading, we are going to do the linking. Whereas dynamic linking, during the execution, that means you have submitted the program, program is started loading, program is started linking, program is almost executable stage. Then if anything linking is required, it will try to link. Best example will be our, what you call, printf and stuff like that. Suddenly you call a function. So when you are calling a function, at the time of execution has started, you are about to go to the program execution, you are middle of the program, suddenly you get a call for another subroutine. The subroutine is already linked into the system, but it has to be connected to your program. Maybe some regions it might not be connected. Then if that is the case, dynamic linking might be used to connect such programs. That means the program is getting loaded. Maybe a possible linking also takes place when system is almost into the middle of the execution. If that is the case, we call it as a during the execution time. If you are going to what is a link or load the program. For example, you have a main program is halfway execution. Suddenly there is a call for a subroutine. What will happen now? Subroutine will be fetched. So what your operating system will do? Okay, let me get the subroutine and start loading into the system. That is going to be a process called as a dynamic linking. So certain programs may be required for a that particular process of a dynamic linking. So this is the one way of a, or maybe another way of a loader design. So totally we have five loaders designs: absolute loader, bootstrap loader we have seen already, linking loader also we have seen so far with the two pass loader concept, where linking is going to be done when you submit the program for the execution. It will not be done before that. Whereas in the case of a linkage editor, as the name says editor, it keeps the ground open for the linking of the program or programs rather before the or prior to the actual execution, well in advance. We can say that linkage editor is going to make sure that linkage is performed well in advance. Maybe after 1 hour, 2 hour, if you want to execute, now only it will keep things ready. If that is the case, we call it as a linkage editor. Whereas a dynamic linking, almost you are middle of the execution time, then it realizes that there is a requirement for a particular subroutine or a program, then it is going to be loaded. This normally happens for a library programs. That means a library programs, for example, printf. You require printf in a program, and printf you have loaded already into the system, and it is not coming to your program. It may not be connected directly to your program. If that is the case, probably what happens when you call printf for the first time, it will be brought into the memory. It will be kept in the memory for some more time, like a cache memory. You know the cache memory, you know how the temporal aspect of a locality of reference will make sure that the one what is brought into the memory, it will be staying for some more time, that spatial locality of reference or a temporal locality of reference. Based on any of them, your program is going to, or your resource will be staying in the memory for some time until another need of a storage comes. Otherwise it will be there for some time. So that printf, once it is brought into the system, it will be staying for some time, is assuming that it might be required for a some other program to be used. So that is the case, dynamic linking happens when program is under execution, during execution we can say. So this is how we can differentiate between a linking loader, linkage editor and dynamic linking. So let us look at some of the diagrams so that it will be easy for you to understand what is linkage editor and a dynamic link. Any doubts at this point of time to differentiate between what is a linking loader, what is a linkage editor, what is a dynamic linking? Any doubts so far? Any clarity required? Okay, fine. So linkage editor performs the actual linking before the loading of the program or before execution of the program. That is the concept of a linkage editor. If you look at the diagram, so this is the diagram. So we have our library. This library will be used to link you to your program. Your object program is staying in memory. When you start execution, normally what will happen? Both will be clubbed together, given to the memory directly. So loader will perform all the linkage. Now we have a in between something that is a linking loader. So it is going to happen before actual loading, well in advance. So what it will do now, the library what you have used, the printf and all, clubbed with the object program that we have and kept the intermediate program in memory. Later when you submit for the execution, that will be used for the storage or loading into the system. Until then, we say that the linking has been performed before or in advance to the actual loading. This is how the concept of a linking loader we have seen. So this is what we do in a linking loader. So linking loader means what we have seen so far. That loader is going to take library, object program, club together, submit to the memory. So this is what happens in our regular scenario. But what we are talking now is linkage editor. So linkage editor is the concept of this one. So linkage editor is the one which keeps the data well in advance. So the linkage editor is going to club the object program, library, put together and keeps that repository as a program. That will not be loaded immediately until the program command gives is given to the what you call execution. So see, look at the previous diagram. So previous diagram is we have a library which contains your printf, scanf statement, stuff like that. We have an object program. These two will be linked together. Library need not be always your printf, scanf also. It may be any resource. While object program can be more than one program. So it can be linking of object programs or linking object programs with the library. So both will be clubbed together. Immediately they will be released for the loading of the program. That is the basic concept of a linking load. There is no intermediate step here. Whereas in the case of a linkage editor, you have a library, you have an object program, of course they are the resources, then put together we have a linkage editor. So this linkage editor will make sure that they will be linked together pre, well in advance to the relocation or a actual loading. So they will be called as a some linked program. They will be existing as a an intermediate program. Later, whenever you submit for execution, at that point of time possible relocation will be taking place, then loading will be taking place, then we'll have a program getting executed. So that is the concept of a linkage editor, wherein the linking takes place well in advance of the actual loading of the program. Now we'll see one more called as a dynamic linking. First, let me take the diagrams easy for you so that you can understand the concept. So dynamic linking. So look at the first diagram now. So first diagram is what? I have submitted the program. User program is there. User program is submitted. This is entire memory. This is a memory. In memory, we know that it will be used at a different places. No memory will be used continuously. Depending upon the available memory at this point of time, your memory will be fragmented and your data will be or program will be stored. There is no question that you start from 1000 today, it will go continuously growing. No, your program may be at sometimes at 1000, some other times at maybe 1 lakh. So remaining in between, some 50,000 bytes may be free. It all depends on the operating system, how it needs to do. But whatever it is, what you should know that memory always will not be in a continuous locations or continuous repository. It is going to be spread across at a different parts of the memory, which you call it as a fragmentation. For some various purposes, OS will be doing that. Now, these are all black areas or empty areas. We are not worried. It may be something existing, something not. But what we need to do now, my program is at some location. This is the location where my program is. That is my user program. This user program now wants to call some loader called as a dynamic loader for some purpose. Assume now it is going to call a dynamic loader. This is to demonstrate how dynamic linking or dynamic loading is going to happen. So when I call a dynamic loader, what will happen? Dynamic loader is available in library or in a operating system. So what you will do now, so user program control will go to operating system. From operating system, control will go to library because it is not available with us. Library may be your secondary storage also. So from that place, it will be stored somewhere. So from secondary storage, the library, what you want? You want a function called as a error handle. You want to have that. So that is going to be stored into your memory now. So earlier it was only user program. Now whatever you have asked now, that also will be joining to main memory. Okay, that's what happening through the dynamic. That means the program is under execution. The program is under execution. During the program execution, you are having a request to dynamic loader that I want a this particular function. So that function is getting fetched to us and stored here. Now, once that is done, now we have user program, we have error handle which is available. Now control will be, so you have asked dynamic loader to give that. No dynamic loader has given, but simply loading into program is not enough. The control has to come back to the user program telling that, okay, you can execute this. So user program execution means the control from dynamic loader will come to the error handle like a subroutine. Subroutine gets executed. When subroutine gets executed, the control will be given back to the dynamic loader. Dynamic loader will in turn inform the user program that, look, you have asked for a program. That program has been brought into memory and that got executed. So purpose is served. So that is what the process is. So in the previous one, we have a user program. User program is requesting for a function. That function is being loaded by the dynamic loader. But dynamic loader does not have that. What it will do now? It will ask for a library. A library will store that back into memory. So when it is stored back into memory, control has to be given from dynamic memory to the function. So function gets executed. Once execution is over, the control is given back to the calling function. For this calling function is dynamic loader. Now dynamic loader will inform the user program that your program request, that is error handle, has been completed. So what is the dynamic here now? So dynamic here means when program is getting executed, during the execution process, there is a need for a function, there is a need for some resource. That resource has been brought by operating system into this. So operating system means it is a dynamic loader, which is a part of your operating system, which is enabling us to provide that data. But that is not the end here. This is one part of the dynamic loader. What dynamic loader will do now? It will make sure that, okay, anyhow, I brought this error handle once into the memory. So let me keep this with me for some time. Later, some other program might be asked to have or might require this particular program. So thereby, it will be kept in here. So when another program or the same program, see in this diagram, what is happening? The same program is again asking for the same function. That means a function can be asked or executed multiple times, isn't it? So in the same fashion, if this program or some other program is asking the same function to be executed again, it will not go to library now, because the program is already available in the memory. It will directly execute. So dynamic linking serves two purposes. One, fetching the required resource or a function during the execution time. Second, for subsequent usages, it will directly use what is there in the memory, meaning that it will not send it back to the secondary storage or the original place, that is library in our case. It will still keep this with you, with this in line with the cache memory concept. Later, for subsequent utilization of that particular function or a call for that particular function, the same thing will be reused. Thereby, it is avoiding the process of fetching the data every time from the library. Once it is brought into the system, it will be there for some time. That's what we have seen from the cache memory point of view. This is what is going to be actual idea behind that. So this is the concept of a dynamic linking or a dynamic loading, meaning that whenever there is a need during the execution of the program, then only that particular function will be fetched. Till then, it will not be fetched. That means before loading, that function is not going to be considered. So before loading, there are two concepts which will deal with the loading. One is the linkage editor and the linking loader. So linking loader will perform just about to execute. The linking process will be done by the linking loader. Whereas the linkage editor, well in advance, linking will be taking place. That is the concept of a linkage editor. So these are the three basic concepts behind the design options of a linking loader, linkage editor, and dynamic linking. So any doubts here? Any clarity required? No doubts? Okay, now, so that concludes our discussion with the loaders. So take assignment for loaders. So two assignments have been given to you. Now this is going to be third assignment. In third assignment, I am adding only two questions as of now. So keep these two questions, and one more I will add right now. So three questions probably will keep with you, and remaining two will be pending. So once those two are added, then you can submit the third assignment. Until then, don't submit. Keep the solution ready. So you can take the assignment. So first assignment, first question for assignment is, write a note on MS-DOS linker. Is a part of syllabus actually, like what you have taken for a Spark, Ultra Spark and VAX. Similar to that, we have MASM assembler earlier, Spark assembler. Now again, we have a MS-DOS linker and SunOS linker. These are real-time systems which are available in real market. So those things you can take as a case study and write a note on that. So how MS-DOS linker works, and how SunOS linker works. Then third question here is differentiate between linking loader, linkage editor, and dynamic linking. All three. You can write a table with the three headings and try to differentiate, try to compare each other. So whenever there is a question on this, the dynamic editing editor or a linkage editor, we have to write these diagrams. Without diagrams, marks will not be given because there is no much to write here, but there is more to explain through the diagram. So if you write the diagram, so probably explanation also will be easier and examiner will come to know that you know the process. So writing diagram is important whenever you talk about linkage editor, linking loader, or dynamic linking. So three questions: MS DOS linker, SunOS linker, and differentiate or distinguish between dynamic linking, linkage editor, and linking loader. So two more questions I will give later when you go to the next module. But till then, don't submit. Keep the solution ready with you. Now, coming to the syllabus for the test, that is IA test. So we have completed assemblers up to data structures, I believe. Now, post that is from relocation onwards till the end of the assemblers, that is complete assemblers from relocation. Next, complete loaders till this, that is till SunOS linker. This is also part of syllabus. So complete loaders and linkers is going to be your syllabus for the second test. So any doubts here? Any clarity required? No doubts? Okay. Any doubts on the syllabus for the test? Okay.